governments tell their own people what they should and should not do with their bodies. It is worse when they tell other people, other cultures that they do not necessarily understand, that they are not a part of what they should do with their own bodies. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm here to tell you why the growing of the coca leaf should absolutely be legalized. I will tell you three reasons why this is so. Firstly, that it is not a narcotic in the sense that we define narcotics. Secondly, it is part of the tradition and livelihood of the people who grow the coca leaf. Thirdly, that it has many economic benefits, and this is more of an added advantage of legalizing the growing of the coca leaf. I will also refute the argument that the growing of coca leaf being legalized will lead to an increase in cocaine production, and this is dangerous for society. So, the coca leaf is not a narcotic. Its psychoactive effects are comparable to that of caffeine. It is only when its resin and paste is extracted is that it becomes a narcotic. Chewing the coca leaf, it has certain health benefits even. It has benefits in regards to reducing obesity. And this has been agreed to by the World Health Organization. It does not classify it as a narcotic. Secondly, it is part of the tradition of these societies to chew the coca leaf. And we are in no place to tell them that their traditions are wrong. I understand that some people might raise the issue that even rape is a tradition in some societies. Doesn't mean we should capitulate to traditions. But the chewing of coca leaf does not harm other people. Therefore, it is not our place to tell these people what is wrong and what is right. And also, it has been part of the tradition since 3000 BC. This is not something we can legislate. Also, the second part is that many people are dependent on growing the coca leaf as a means of their livelihood, and we cannot take this away from them unless we give them a certain alternative which to work. But I'm not entirely in favor of giving them any alternatives at all. Let them grow the coca leaf because it has no comparable harms. Thirdly, there are many economic benefits to the coca leaf that aren't yet realized. Some of them are. The coca leaf is used in small quantities in some soft drinks in the Western world. It can also be used as an anesthetic. There are several companies that are looking at using it in shampoos, in soaps, and other such items. So it can, if legalized, and when it is legal, it can give farmers economic benefits when there are legal markets that they can tap. Now, I will refute the argument that legalizing the growing of coca leaf will be a problem because it will increase cocaine consumption and use. In an ideal world, I would legalize cocaine consumption and use, but since certain governments will not do it, I think this is not the right way to go about it, because when you have illegal growing of the coca leaf and you have illegal cocaine trade, you have two illegal things instead of one, and then you have to crack down on both of them, and that costs you more money than simply cracking down on illegal trade, on the illegal production of cocaine. There are also certain substances used in amphetamine, like safrole. It is used in the chemical and pharmaceutical industries, and it is an ingredient that is very, very essential to these industries. Doesn't mean that we make that the ingredient illegal. It just means that we make the final substance illegal, amphetamines, methamphetamines. So therefore, the coca leaves should not be illegal. I also think that supply reduction as a strategy is a failed strategy. We can take the example of Afghanistan, where after millions of troops being sent in, the cultivation of the poppy plant has grown and it has gone into the hands of the Taliban. Therefore, the illegalization of the growing of coca leaf is a supply reduction strategy, and supply reduction strategies have been shown not to work. Therefore, we should keep the growing of the coca leaf illegal. I think it is patronizing and downright bullying when developed countries or any countries, powerful countries, tell other countries what their population should and should not be doing. when it does not affect them in any harmful way, and even if it does, I think this is a case of consumer countries shifting the blame to producer countries. Like Thoreau said, it is our duty, just as it is our duty to follow a good law, it is also our duty to oppose a bad law. I'm sure he said that in a much better way, and he was better with words than I am, but I think the opposition by Bolivia to the law banning coca consumption, the coca production, coca leaf production, is the right thing to do, and it must be opposed if raised again. I also think that a certain stance, this stance on the legalization of the growing of coca leaf, is also a part of the larger issue of policy pluralism within the drug laws and the international drug regime. Therefore, the growing of the coca leaf should be legalized for the three reasons I told you. One, that it is not a narcotic. Two, that it is part of the tradition and livelihood of many communities. Three, and an added benefit, it has many economic uses that can make the farmers economically well off. I've also refuted the argument that growing of the coca leaf is harmful because coca is used in cocaine production. Thank you.